Aloha ahi ahi. Good evening, everyone. The Rainbow Wahine welcomes you to Simplify Arena at Stan Sheriff Center. On the campus of the University of Hawaii in majestic Manoa, for night two of the 33rd Hawaiian Airlines Rainbow Wahine Classic. Tonight's second contest matches West Coast Conference member, the 13th ranked San Diego Toreros, versus the reigning Big West champions, your Hawaii Rainbow Wahine. Introducing the San Diego Toreros starting lineup. At outside hitter, 5'11 freshman from Chandler, Arizona, number one, Nemo Beach. At middle blocker, 6'4 senior from San Diego, California, number seven, Layla Blackwell. At middle blocker, 6'1 junior from San Marcos, California, number eight, Haley Stoner. At center, 5'9 senior from Waverly, Arizona, number 10, Ani Evans. At opposite, 6'4 junior from Falmouth, Maine, number 14, Annika Hester. At libero, 5'8 senior from Temecula, California, number 19, Maddie Allen. And at outside hitter, 6'2 senior from San Juan Capistrano, California, floor captain number 20, Kylie Priest. The graduate assistant is Casey Shaneline. Assistant coach, Jimmy Lundgren. Associate head coach, Carlos Moreno. Head coach for the Toreros, Jennifer Petrie.
New life, pray for new breath. Hey Lord, make sure it's safe for who's left. Know you can't find a place to rest. Know the world, my bullet, proof vest. When we
and set out, now, we keep the starting lineup for your Hawaii Rainbow Wahine. And middle blocker, 6'3 senior from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, number three, Amber Igidi. And outside hitter, 6 foot senior from Dublin, Ohio, floor captain, number six, Riley Wagner. And opposite, 5'11 freshman from Kfar Saba, Israel, number nine, Tally Hakas. At Center, 5'10", junior from Keller, Texas, number 10, Caitlin! And middle blocker, 6'2", senior from Twin Falls, Idaho, number 12, Kennedy Evans! Libero, 5'7", senior from Kalamazoo, Michigan, number 13, Talia Edmonds! And an outside hitter, 6-foot sophomore from Alpharetta, Georgia, number 17, Kaylin Alexander! Volunteer assistant Skylin Engelman. Assistant coaches Kaleo Baxter and Nick Castello. Head coach for your Rainbow Wahine, Robin Amo.
American middle Amber Igeti led the Rainbow Wahine volleyball team to an opening night victory last night in a topsy-turvy 5-set thriller against Northwestern. Tonight, Hawai'i faces another challenge in perennial WCC powerhouse San Diego, coming off the program's first ever Final Four appearance last season. It's a Saturday night showdown between the 13th-ranked Toreros of San Diego and the Hawai'i Rainbow Wahine. And with that, we welcome you inside Simplify Arena at Stan Sheriff Center. Kanoa Leahy sitting next to Chris McLaughlin. C-Mac, take us through the Kaiser Permanente keys to the match.
For USD, can the newbies handle the stand? Well, six new players will all contribute. Four have never seen crowds like this. And for Hawai'i, bring their best serves. The Torero's strength is in the middle. And for the middles to get swings, they'll need good passes off those tough UH serves.
A couple of different experiences for these two teams on night one of this Hawaiian Airlines Rainbow Wahine Classic. Hawai'i able to pull it out down 2-1 last night, able to pull out the victory in five. So starting the season 1-0. On the other side, though, San Diego, they got swept by Oregon, and they only hit .062 as a team in that match.
Not good, but watch tonight. I think Kanoa for both sides to set the middle early and often.
So the first serve is Kylie Priest bringing it across. Hawai'i goes outside. Riley Wagner, who had a ton of attempts last night, already gets her second try. Down the line it goes, and it's going to go in for a kill.
Oh, I like that little line shot from Riley. Hitting it deep over the center's head. Well placed.
Hawaiian Financial FCU starting lineup scrolling at the bottom of your screen. Same starting lineup for Hawai'i, including for the second night here in this weekend's tournament. You have Talia Edmonds wearing the libero jersey for Hawai'i.
She worked hard during the 2-a-days. She's earned that jersey.
San Diego out of system. Here's Nemo Beach. Had 10 kills last night against Oregon, one of the bright spots. Amber Igeti off of 1 foot, couldn't get it down. Good save there by Maddie Allen. Punched over by Beach. Nemo Beach, what a story she's turning into here in this tournament. 5'11 freshman from Chandler, Arizona. Again, 10 kills last night. Hit 400 against Oregon. Six of those kills did come in the first set, so just four the rest of the way. But a freshman who shined amid some chaos against the Ducks last night.
Yeah, she had zero errors in that first set.
Igeti again on the slide. Set was a little off the net. It doesn't matter for Amber. She's able to make it work. 14 kills for her. 33 attempts last night against Northwestern. Hit 303. Oh, and also had 9 blocks.
Notice that two of the first three sets went where? To Amber Igeti.
Asked you about this in the game on portion of the broadcast. 33 attempts over 5 sets, mind you. Is that enough for Amber Igeti?
Look if she gets... So 33 divided by 5, she's got, that's about 6 sets a game. I think for tonight, she'll average at least 6 sets per set. Maybe more. maybe seven.
I think Robin Amo would be fond of the idea of upticking that number a little bit, just like you're alluding to.
Kind of depends how good the passing is, right?
That is absolutely true. Right side, here is the swing for San Diego. That was Hester who got dug up, and then there she is again. Amber Igidi, early and often, number three, with her second kill.
I told you Igidi would get set a lot tonight, didn't I? Or was it you told me?
It was a mutual discussion.
She turned around right away and pointed to Riley Wagner, the server, who forced that overpass with a great serve. Amber, ever the unselfish player.
Amber Igidi off and running here. Already with three kills. That's a good pass there. Right side. This is Hester. And Annika Hester hits it wide. That's now five straight points for the Rainbow Wahine. Robin Amo, the reigning Big West Conference Coach of the Year. In fact, she's won it effectively the last three seasons.
Saw that hitting error right there, Cano. Last night, 26 hitting errors for San Diego. They're trying to cut that number down just a little bit.
Robin Amo also with 109 career victories now to her ledger as Nemo Beach goes off the block and out. So Beach with two kills. A true freshman, Arizona Gatorade State Player of the Year as a senior at Hamilton High School.
I'm sure her mom, Keisha, is watching right now, or maybe she's in the audience.
And here is Alex Hoagland. So San Diego, we saw this at the tail end of the match last night against Oregon, and Jennifer Petrie telling us that it was something that she would possibly turn to. They could possibly go to a two-setter system, which is the appearance that they're taking on here. As Amber Igidi gets blocked back on the slide. Here is Kaylin Alexander from the outside position, and she makes it work. And you start to see the balance here very early on in this first frame, though, C-Mac, but a lot of sets going to Amber, and then all of a sudden opens things up for the pin hitters.
Absolutely. One of the fans wrote to me last night and said, you know what? I think the offense just needs a little WD-40. And I think that's happening right now. Pretty smooth offense right now.
Well, you up a handful. Outside, Amber Stivrins unable to make it work there on that set. 6'2 grad student, preseason all West Coast Conference. And Hawai'i up by six already here in this first frame. Jennifer Petrie signaling for a timeout.
University of Hawai'i Sports on Spectrum OC16.
Hawai'i siding out at a 100% rate, San Diego at 28% rate.
Outside, this is Stivrins, touch shot, good save there by Tally Hawkes, and then Alexander got blocked back. Hawai'i will play it back. Kennedy Evans off of 1 foot, and she's denied. Stivrins was out there on the pin, and she was jumping up next to Layla Blackwell. That is a pretty formidable block there, 6'4 and 6'4. Stivrins, who spent the previous three seasons at Georgia after an ACC all-freshman campaign at Louisville all the way back in 2019.
Yeah, third college in 4 years.
Oh, and that's an ace. So just like that, San Diego back-to-back points. And inching closer here in the first frame. Good serve there by Olivia Bennett, 5'5 sophomore from Lexington, Kentucky. Had 10 digs in the loss last night to Oregon. Low line drive serve, pulls Lang off the net. Here's Alexander, has to left hand touch it over. Advantage Toreros, outside Stivrins through the block. And she gets the point. Stivrins had 8 kills, hit 158 with a handful of digs last night against the Ducks. But San Diego, after that early timeout by Jennifer Petrie, seems to have found a little bit of focus. Here's Alexander, gets a full swing there and cut it like a thin slice of bread.
Got a little too much cable, I think, for her liking, but a kill nevertheless.
Alexander went for 12 kills last night in the five-set victory over Northwestern. 38 attempts, hit 105. Certainly you'd like to see the percentage increase there. Hit 237 for the season in 2022. Here's Kate Lang, had a several really good service runs last night against the Wildcats. And that middle set goes to Blackwell, the 6'4 senior from San Diego, California. However, she got to San Diego via Indiana.
It's She only spent 1 year there and then transferred to San Diego and has had a good career at San Diego so far. But last night, really struggled against number nine, Oregon.
Here's Hakas. Oh, boy. Unloaded there. What a dig, though, to keep it alive. Outside Stivrin's touch shot blocked back by Alexander. Now the middle, and that one is just shoved past the block by Haley Stoner. So the two middles, we've already seen them, Blackwell and now Stoner, according to head coach Jennifer Petrie, really two of the established leaders of this squad. A lot of turnover, as you alluded to, from that incredible team from a season ago.
Last night, Stoner hitting 0-0-0, looking to up that average tonight for sure.
San Diego within two. And that's a diving save there by Talia Edmonds, touched over by Evans. Right side, the swing by Freese is blocked back. Outside, Stivrins, the door is shut closed. Kaylin Alexander saying,
This is one area in which I think Kaylin Alexander has really improved. Her line blocking, you know, she goes straight up, no swinging arms, just straight up and down, forcing the ball back into the court. Much more disciplined than she was last year.
And now with the serve, sent a bunch of serves long, and she does so right there. Hasn't quite calibrated here in this opening weekend from the service line. Remember, she led the team in aces a season ago.
You're seeing Tammy Ikenaga a little earlier tonight than last night. Last night she didn't come in, I think, till set four. Tonight coming in for Kaylin Alexander. See if she steadies out in the back row.
Kaylin Ikenaga, the starting libero's since her freshman campaign, which is what made Talia Edmonds donning the libero jersey here these first two nights. Such a noteworthy change in the lineup. But good to see them both out there, as we saw a multitude of times throughout the season last year.
It was a hard-fought battle down there here, day in and day out. You know, they're being statted every day. They were fighting for that position, that's for sure.
Here is Edmonds now to serve, a sixth-year senior. Truly one of the vocal leaders here for Hawai'i this season. Goes to that deep corner, the pass by Priest. She'll get the high ball bump set. Diving save there by Lang. Hakas just going to two-hand it over. So advantage here with the Toreros. They go middle to Stoner.
Did I tell you to be middles a lot early and often on both sides?
Middles for days here in this matchup. San Diego and Hawai'i.
Jen Petrie made no bones about it that the middles are their strength.
Good pass there by Ikenaga. Aijiri in the middle.
She had a little hang time there. Notice that? She was a little early and had to wait. That's set to go up from Lang. And well, she says, wait, hang, and then put it down.
That's pretty remarkable.
Well, it pays to be a great athlete, I guess, doesn't
it? I guess so.
You know what that's like, don't you?
No, totally.
When you used to play basketball, you used to have a lot of hang time?
I was bolted to the ground, C-Man. Here's Beach. Oh, that was heavy-handed. What a dig, Ikenaga. Aijiri does it again. Net violation, San Diego. It doesn't matter. But what you back up for? Amber Aijiri. Providing a heavy dose in that middle position tonight.
And how about the dig from Ikenaga? Not really made the play. And Jeannie points to Lang for the good set, but she also points to Ikenaga.
Now the serve by Hakas, though, goes long. That'll be an interesting debate here throughout the season. Who displays more emotion on a constant basis? Is it Tali Hakas? We saw that throughout the match last night. Or is it Amber Aijiri? That's going to be a neck and neck one.
That's right.
Lang goes high and away. Here's Wagner, tip shot. Right there is Beach. Right side, this is Hester. Two-hand save there, Edmonds. So Lang high balls it again to Wagner. And she is denied. Monica Hester getting the gist of that one. 6'4", redshirt junior from Falmouth, Maine.
This is a big block, 6'4 and 6'4. Not many places to go except maybe off the right hand of the outside blocker or high hands. I'm glad she didn't tip it though. I'm glad she was aggressive.
Aijiri off of one leg. She has six kills here in set one.
And yet to make an error. hitting a mere 750. A good night for middle would be something over 400, so 750 is lofty, to say the least.
San Diego out of system here. Beach trying to better the ball, and she blasts it long. And Hawai'i gets to 15 first. They'll keep playing by virtue of the early timeout taken by Jennifer Petrie. San Diego hitting 050. Hawai'i hitting 381. And that's an ace. Riley Wagner deals it out of the deck.
We may see another timeout coming up here. If Hawai'i gets another point, I think Petrie will try to slow things down.
How much of this is an uptick in the sharpness of Hawai'i versus perhaps a little bit of a disjointedness on the side of San Diego?
Combination.
Back-to-back aces. How about that for a combination? A little 1-2 from Riley Wagner, and Hawai'i has its largest lead of set one. Timeout, Toreros. Welcome back. Time now for the Hawai'i Honda Dealers highlight reel and a whole bunch of highlights put together by Amber Igidi. She is off to the races here in this match, C-Mac.
It's basically the Amber Igidi show here in set number one. She came out firing, and I think that Kate Lang was given some instructions to possibly set Amber more often.
And she has been cooking here. Six kills, eight attempts, no errors. And Riley Wagner, back-to-back aces. That one just tickled the tape. From the right side, that's Hester. And able to find that pathway right down Kalakaua Avenue for the kill. Much needed point out of the timeout by San Diego. Toreros coming off of a season, we mentioned, made it to the Final Four, reached as high as number two in the national rankings. Went 31-2. They went unbeaten through the West Coast Conference, 18-0.
That was pretty amazing. That's not an easy conference.
No, not at all. Eventually lost to the eventual national champion, Texas, in the national semifinal. The only other loss last season was to then number three ranked Louisville. That was earlier in the year in the Cardinal Classic.
And they took sets off Texas and a set off Louisville.
These two teams met last year as well. It was in the Texas A&M Invitational. San Diego won in three as Amber Igidi tried to bump it over the net, but it hit the pin. And so a free point gifted, if you will, to San Diego. But you talked about some of what San Diego lost. Six seniors, including All-Americans, setter Gabby Blossom, who was just fantastic, opposite Grace Frawling, outside hitter Katie Lutz, among others. That is just a whole lot of firepower to have to replace as they go into now this next campaign. But make no mistake, Jennifer Petrie is very quick to end any kind of discussion about what happened last year. She says, no, this is a different team. Any talk about last year versus this year is a waste of our time.
Yeah, and she's really trying to bring the six new people into the fold ASAP.
Outside, that's a good swing there by Priest. Tyler Priest, a true senior, floor captain as well, 6'2 senior from San Juan Capistrano, California, fourth year with the program. Hit negative against Oregon last night with six kills.
Really struggled last night. Six kills, 11 errors. It was a tough night for her. She's aiming to turn that around. Highly motivated to play better tonight.
Hawai'i up a handful. Here's Hakas. Oh, she hung a little bit there, but a great dig by Maddie Allen, and then putting in work from the outside is Amber Stivers. So the Toreros, Amber, getting in on the action.
Stivers, interesting background of the schools that she went. She made all freshman team at Louisville. They went to the Elite Eight that year, so she's got some NCAA background.
Overpass by Hakas, slammed down by Stoner. And just like that, Toreros on the comeback trail, forcing a timeout by Robin Amo and the Rainbow Wahine. Things have dipped just a bit here for Hawai'i, C-Mac.
Yeah, not surprising that San Diego would pull out of the tailspin they were in. they're bound to play better. We got so many players that are motivated to play better tonight. They hit for poor percentages, and we're really disappointed that they and their performances. And there you see the whole gang.
Kind of interesting their setup here in the timeout, huh? It's like they're posing for a team photo.
Actually, I think part of it is to make sure that everybody hears Coach Petrie's instructions. And number two, the fans aren't going to be listening in. Even our Ryan Clay Tsuji might have trouble hearing what Petrie's saying.
Well, speak of Ryan, let's go to him now. Ryan, what's up?
Hey, you know, I find a way to listen in, regardless if there's a wall of players in front of me. Coach Petrie, we're here talking to her team. One of the things she's really emphasizing is their passing, saying Hawaii's pushing us back. She really wants her players to move their feet because right now their passing is just not allowing their offense to run anything, trying to suggest their passers to do a better job of getting into a better position. They're also saying, watch number three. Let's make sure we have two up at all time. Of course, number three, Amber Aijidi, having a way right now in this first set. San Diego looking for a way to slow down the All-American. Back over to you guys.
Thanks a lot, Ryan. You know, we talked about some of what San Diego lost personnel-wise on the roster, but also should mention one of the great assistants that has really helped Jennifer Petrie, according to her, along the way here in recent years, taking the UCLA head coaching job, and that is former Hawaii men's libero Alfie Reft. So a big loss in the coaching department as well as some of the losses on the roster.
Absolutely. Really, really tough for her to do. She had two good assistants, though. You know, she's got Carlos Moreno and Jimmy Lundgren.
Of course, UCLA head coaching position, formerly held by Mike Seeley. And there is Stivrins again going off of Alexander and out. And Hawaii stuck in the mud here a little bit late in set one.
Well, they're not playing that badly. It's just that San Diego has bumped it up a notch here.
That's now four straight points for the Toreros. You can expand that over to a 6-2 run. Hawkins with the pass. Here's Alexander. Two blockers up. She goes long. Was there a touch? No touch. It is a one-point contest here in the first frame. Largest lead for Hawaii was six. It's down to one.
Some self-inflicted wounds are going on here.
Maddie Allen, another senior on the roster with the serve. She has caused some problems here. Here's Kennedy Evans. What an up there by Allen. Stivrins on the outside. Off the block and down. Not exactly bringing the heat, but they're just putting it in the right spots here on the Hawaii side of the floor, and it is all knotted up.
Stivers with five kills now to lead all Toreros.
Six straight points. And Hawkins having some trouble in serve receive, has to knuckle it over. Advantage San Diego. Right side, it's Priest. Diving save, Wagner, what an up. Hawkins from off the net. And the dig there by Stivrin. Toreros in transition. Priest again. And that's going to be a Hawaii point. I'm going to say that it hit the antenna before it hit the Hawaii hands. And the Rainbow Wahine get out of that rotation at long last.
Ooh, they were stuck there for a while. Like your comment, they were stuck in the mud.
See, it hit the top of the net, and then, at least according to top official Wayne Lee, hit the antenna off of the ricochet, but Toreros go right back to work. Haley Stoner smacking it down. So here we go. This is the practice gym drill. 2020, race to five. What you got?
There you go.
Stivrins to serve. Led the SEC in 2021 with 47 aces. Here's Evans, and it goes out. And San Diego jumps in front. First lead of this opening set for the Toreros, trailed by as many as six. Lang gonna go outside Wagner, two blockers up, and she's able to tool it. And we're tied at 21, and guess who rotating back into the front row?
Would it be number three, Amber Aijidi?
It would be.
Well, he's gonna have some offense these last 4 points.
Talia Edmonds to serve. 21 all in the first. Off the slide, it's Stoner dug up by Lang. Edmonds. It's going to be Hawkins. Two blockers up. She's blocked. Able to play it off the net. Tipped over by Wagner. Torero's on the attack. Outside, the tip by Priest. Saved by Aijidi. Lang has to dig it out of no man's land. And then Aijidi two hands it over, but they're going to call her for the miss hit.
Ooh, that's a tough one to take. Subjective call. The crowd does not like it. I didn't think it stuck in her hands that long, even hit twice.
Definitely seen worse. Well,
slow motion Kenny doesn't show up. And it's a non-challengeable call.
Definitely have seen worse than that.
Yeah,
go without sure. being called.
For sure.
Good pass there by Wagner. Here's Aijidi. Kill number seven. And we're tied for the fifth time here in set one. Well, Kate Lang seems to have gotten the memo as far as looking to Amber Aijidi. She's already had 10 attempts here in this first frame. Here's Beach, blocked back. Good cover there by Allen. Beach close to the net, blocked, but it goes off of Aijidi and out, and it's a point for San Diego. Aijidi was pleading with Robin Amoa to challenge the ball, but Robin was standing at a pretty good angle. I think she saw it clearly.
I think she overruled Amber there. Because if she makes the challenge and she loses it, then she's only got one challenge left the rest of the match until the fifth set.
23-22. That pass tight to the net. A little joust up there. Torero's control. It's Beach from off the net. Off the fingertips. Ikenaga with the save. Lang goes slide. Aijidi blocked. Oh, the cover by Hawkins. High ball set. Wagner. Cross court. It's dug up. Rattled around. And now Beach will get a swing out of it. And she makes it work. Nemo Beach with a huge out-of-system play for her fourth termination.
Arizona Gatorade Player of the Year. Just a freshman playing lights out two nights in a row now.
San Diego trailed by as many as a half dozen. The timeout by Hawai'i, and when they come back from the bench areas, it's going to be aloha ball for the Toreros, C-Mac. How did this happen?
A little bit of Hawai'i's self-inflicted wounds and a little bit of San Diego just playing better. You know, they're just they're setting the middles more. They're passing better. Everything just functioning better on their side of the net compared to last night when it seemed like everything went wrong. They had 26 hitting errors last night. They're being better about keeping the ball in play. Last night they averaged 8 errors a set in hitting, and that was not good. So they're playing better tonight, much higher percentage volleyball.
And it seemed like Hawai'i really started to struggle over this later portion of the first set in serve receives. You saw them sort of picking on Tally Hawkins for several serves in a row there along that stretch where they were able to make that 6-0 run and get right back into this.
Yeah, they were really serving tough. Stivers had some just line drives. Riley Wagner, too. Wagner handled pretty good, but they weren't perfect enough to set the middles. That was the problem. And so credit to San Diego serving. They bumped that up. They ramped that up big time.
And also, that run coming, not by coincidence, when Amber Aijidi was off the floor. She's back on the floor, but now Hawai'i has to play perfect here. Aloha Ball San Diego, the 13th ranked team in the country, coming off of a sweep defeat against number 9 Oregon last night. Trying to bounce back. They've bounced back in this first set. Can they finish the deal? Lang, bump set to Hawkins. That's dug up by Stoner, and it's a nice dig. Beach, the left-handed tip, save there, Hawkins. Here's Aijidi in the middle, gets it down. Kill number 8 for Amber.
8 kills, 1 error, and 12 tries. 12 attempts here in the first set. Last night she averaged 6%.
Hitting 583. Still Aloha Ball San Diego. Wagner with a good serve. Here's Beach. Blocked! The cover there by Jaworski. Beach a second time off the block. Saved! by Edmonds. Here's Aigidi, the tip. Oh, San Diego going to play it back. High ball bump set. Beach off the fingertips. There's Hawkes. Lang going to go outside. Alexander! And we are knotted up at 24 apiece.
That was a good sequence on both sides. Some good block coverage. Look at the set out to Alexander right where she likes it. Picks on the smaller of the two blockers, luckily. Blackwell's in there now. Maybe their best blocker, arguably. She's 6'4". Certainly don't want to be hitting into her.
So it's deuces here. Wagner forces the overpass. A joust up there. Pinballed around on the Hawaii side in San Diego in transition. It's Blackwell from the opposite spot. Able to find the floor. And Aloha ball once again for San Diego. Oh, Amber Aigidi not able to take advantage. You would think she has the edge in a joust situation like that. But give San Diego credit. They have been scrappy here in this first frame. A set, mind you, that really has exposed a lot of sloppiness on their side, but they've cleaned it up here down the stretch.
Let's see how their serve is here. They've really been serving tough.
Hoagland the serve. Hawkes popped it straight up in the air. Alexander off the block and down. An out ball play by Hawkes, you think?
Absolutely. The ball is 3 feet out easily.
It's deuces again.
Players around her have got to communicate better to her when the ball's in or out, but that one wasn't even close in my opinion.
And now Aigidi will serve. 25 all here. Set one, Hawaii USD. And that was close to being an out ball. Outside, Stiverins pounds it off the hands. Lang has options. Outside, Alexander rips into it.
How about the pass in transition from Amber Aigidi, the middle blocker, and was right on the money.
5 kills for Alexander, hitting 444. And it is Aloha ball for the Rainbow Wahine here in set one. Tight to the net, rattled around, and Hawaii gave up on the play. They thought that it hit the floor. And now Riley Wagner going to have a discussion. She's the floor captain with Wayne Lee. He's going to call Randy Rubinall, the R2, over. They're going to talk about this. It appeared as though Hawaii thought the play had ended, whether the ball hit the floor or there were four touches on the San Diego side.
Backdoor attacker, setter, was above the net, attacking that ball.
So it is a point for Hawaii. They're going to call it, as you said, a back row violation. Hawaii thought that the play had ended. They continued to play on. Let's take a look here. Oh, because there was a simultaneous touch between the setter and Kennedy Evans, the setter being a back row player, that would be considered an attack by the setter.
Exactly.
But the argument here by Jennifer Petrie is that it should have been an interference call on Evans because she's going to argue that the ball was still on the San Diego side. At least that would be her point of view.
Exactly. Watch this again. We'll see where the ball is. Does Evans have a chance at it? Looks like that ball was mostly on San Diego side, but even if a fraction of the ball breaks that plane, it's Kennedy Evans' chance to attack the ball.
Well, an anticlimactic close to what was otherwise an extremely entertaining opening frame. But when the dust clears, Rainbow Wahine take it 27-20. Welcome back. Let's go inside the numbers presented by Long's Drugs. The number is 7, and that's the number of preseason matches or non-conference matches versus 2022 NCAA tournament teams for Hawaii this season. San Diego, one of them, made it to the Final Four. Tomorrow night it'll be Oregon. Next week, 2 matches against USC. Florida State, Pepperdine, and TCU are also on the schedule. TCU and Florida State, part of the Fight in the Fort, which will run from September 14th to September 16th. Over in the Lone Star State. To start the second set,
starting in the back row. Once again, give some credit to Kaleo Baxter. We know him as Gregory Baxter. But he put that schedule together with Robin Amo's blessing. He got the green light to go out and grab as good a team as he could find. And he did a terrific job.
I believe you've also presented him with the moniker Volley Nerd.
Oh.
That came from you, right?
He's proud of it, and he and Eric Shoji are the two biggest volley nerds on the planet. Yeah.
They most definitely are. So set two underway, and how about the one-hand block deflection there by Aijidi, then the one-hand back set to Hakas. Torero's on the attack. It's Priest. Good two-hand punch-up save there by Edmonds, and then it's Aijidi. Just doing Amber Aijidi things. Kill number nine. She left a stamp on that first frame. Hawai'i able to pull it out despite three set points for San Diego compared to the one at the end of that thing for Hawai'i. They took it 27-25.
I liked her kill there at the end, but I like her one-handed block there even better at the beginning of the rally to keep the rally alive.
Stivern's roll shot. Look at the save there by Edmonds. Played off the net by Lang. And then Wagner tight to the net, trying to just do something with it. Here's Hakas on the other side. Went line, but missed wide.
Ooh, she had a wide open shot down the line. She's got to convert there when she's got a one-on-one and a wide open line.
Quite the splashy debut last night for the 5'11 freshman from Israel. 10 kills, hit 179, but had 9 digs. An ace was in on 3 blocks. Aijidi in the middle. Like clockwork, she's already into double figures in kills.
That's pretty amazing.
Hammer time indeed.
I'd be surprised if San Diego doesn't start putting two up on her.
Oh, and that set off the mark intended for Haley Stoner. And so a little discombobulation early here in set two, very similar to what we saw in set one. But to the Toreros' credit, they have championship level pedigree, and so they were able to fight their way back into that first frame. Here's Stoner. She stones it, and a perfect set there from Alex Hoagland.
That was a great set. Stoner up quickly. This took impeccable timing right there. Even Amber couldn't get a piece of it. Great shot by Stoner, great set by Hoagland.
Stoner with 5 kills. She and Amber Stivrens leading the way right now for San Diego. Stivrens with the serve, also with 5 kills. Forces the overpass. Stoner going to swing, and she's going to get a kill, her 6th. And again, serve, receive. Bit of an issue here for Hawai'i tonight.
Yeah, a lot of it is, I'll tell you, San Diego is serving tough. They're serving the ball about maybe less than a meter below the top of the net. And with velocity.
Another good serve. Lang just has to go over on two and puts it in the perfect spot.
Talk about bettering the ball. She took a pass that wasn't that great on top of the net and found a way to get a kill on.
Nate Lang with the ad lib there. 5'10 junior from Keller, Texas. 2-time first team all Big West Conference selection. The Big West Setter of the Year in 2022. The team high 9 double-doubles last year. Near double-double last night against Northwestern. 4 serving 3. Back row set, and Amber says, ahole.
Amber is such a force at the net. If she's not getting kills or is a major distraction for the other team on with blockers, she's getting blocks like that.
I was talking with assistant coach Nick Costello before the match and referred to the number of sets that Aijidi got last night and the debate as to whether or not that's too many or too few. And all he said was, hey, look, she's a specimen. And she's a one in every bunch of years type talent.
Generational.
Yes. And he says, we just got to go to her. And we will basically, in sports terminology, live or die that way.
Yeah.
And there's a good look at Nick. His coaching staff really has gelled here over the last few seasons as well. Saw Kaleo Baxter. The block up there on Alexander by the Toreros. And we're tied at 5.
Much for Alexander to get more sets tonight as well. Hakas, I think, will get more sets too. But that's a great little, you know, Alexander did the right thing there. She's picking on the small blocker. pick on Hoagland, and Hoagland is, you know, she's 5'6". So Alexander did the right thing, just needed to hit a little higher.
There's Igidi dug up there nicely in the back row by Priest. Beach is blocked. Beach a second time goes line, popped up there by Hakas. Wagner will soft touch it over. Here's Beach again. Third time a charm. No, misses the floor, no touch. It's a point for Hawai'i. The Torero players imploring Jennifer Petrie to challenge the call. And I think she will oblige. Haley Stoner coming over and saying, no, that was in. So the challenge, and it will be, I believe, a challenge of the in-out call.
Is it in-out number one?
Yeah, that's the new number system that is implemented here this year. One is in and out, or is one a touch, I should say. One is touch, two is in and out. See, you threw me off already, C-Mac.
They threw us off when they brought that information over last night right before the match started.
Well, did it hit the line is the question. Doesn't appear as though it necessarily hit the sideline. If anything, maybe the end line. Ooh.
Like it's good. I think the call will get reversed.
Yeah, that might be the right call. You know, we were talking about the coaching staff for Hawai'i, and we'd be remiss if we didn't also mention Skylin Engelman, the volunteer coach who has been part of the program for a couple of years now, and then longtime volunteer equipment coordinator, Jimbo Pacella, who's just been around this,
29
this program.
Years.
Yeah, like almost three decades. Anita Sanchez, student manager. So just wanted to make sure we gave a shout out. It really does appear as though this entire staff has a tremendous amount of chemistry. So a successful challenge there for Jennifer Petrie. And instead of Hawai'i being up 6-5, it's San Diego up 6-5 here in the second. And it's also a 3-0 run now for the Toreros. Here's Kylie Priest. And it's an ace. Well, you talked about the tough serving of the Toreros. They're not going to bring you a lot of jump serving, top spin type stuff, but those low line drive, almost knuckleball type serves.
Yeah, very difficult to pass, and they're just barely clearing the net. Makes it very difficult on the passers. So the passers are now stepping up a little bit. They may take one with their hands.
Lang goes outside. Here's Alexander through the block, dug up by Priest on one knee. Beach on the outside. Pummels it. Nemo Beach with her sixth kill, and it is a three-point advantage here for San Diego. They have ripped off five in a row.
Nemo Beach picking up right where she left off last night, where she led the Toreros in kills with 10 and hit 400.
Tip shot there by Igidi, sliding in and saving it one-hand style Maddie Allen. Edmonds with a dig of her own on Hawaii's side. Here is Hakas blocked back. Lang behind the head to Igidi. You knew that was coming. Everyone in the building knew that number three was going to get the call, and she delivers.
There was an audible there, by the way. Amber's been running wide slides all night. All of a sudden, she calls for a tight slide right behind the setter, and it really threw off the San Diego block. You see the outside blocker was going out to the antenna. Instead, nothing. Amber had all sorts of room.
Low line drive serve of her own as well. Here's Beach on the outside, off the net, saved by Igidi in the back row. Here's Hakas from behind the line.
Shee-hoo!
Slide to Stoner blocked. The cover there by Allen. Here's Beach down the line, missed it wide, no touch. Point Hawai'i there within one. I mean, just like last night, these back and forth swings of the pendulum. It has been undulating, the momentum from one side of the other.
It's going to be who's left standing tonight, right?
serve goes just long. Wahine's side thought that that was an ace. No challenge coming from Robin Amo.
It was close, but I think it just missed.
Nine serving seven. Here's Stoner. Again, Hawai'i having problems playing these San Diego serves. That is Blackwell dug up over the net, but out. And San Diego gets to 10.
Once again, Blackwell hitting, I think she had 0-0-0 last night, so she's out to really atone herself and be the middle attacker that she's been purported to be, all WCC type.
On the line, that's a good pass there by Hawkes. Alexander able to tool the block.
That time I think she went off the, again, the smaller outside blocker, Hoagland. Again, San Diego serves are really causing all kinds of problems for Hawai'i.
Yeah, you mentioned a couple of possible adjustments, including moving up there in serve receive, perhaps receiving those serves with two hands. Overpass, Alexander couldn't win the joust. It was won by Hoagland. Hoagland at 5-6, winning that action above the tape against 6 foot Kaylin Alexander.
Yeah, and those jousts, it's very often who pushes last. Let's see, there's the first push by Kaylin Alexander. Hoagland, second push, gets the kill.
And now Hoagland to serve. This one a bit more floaty down the line. Evans, the middle set was a little low. Now tapped around on the San Diego side. Evans the block, and then Beach hits it into the twine. That was just messy from the start. But Hawai'i gets the point. And now Kaylin Alexander will serve. 6 foot sophomore from Alpharetta, Georgia. Big West Conference Freshman of the Year last year. Better serve that time. Middle set Blackwell, two hand save Edmonds. Bump set Wagner, blocked and roofed.
Ooh, big block. Blackwell, you know, she's got a history of being a great blocker. She led the WCC last year in blocking, 1.5 blocks per set. Number six in the NCAA. She's really got the great reach, the press over. Rarely makes a netting error. She's solid.
And a two-time first team all WCC. You mentioned one block for San Diego against Oregon last night. They already have five here tonight against Hawai'i as Kennedy Evans is able to lay into that one, the 6-2. Redshirt senior from Twin Falls, Idaho. Transferred prior to last season from Utah. Injury plagued, though, in recent years. But good to see her healthy, good to see her out there, and good to see her contributing, that's for sure. 10 serving 12. Stivrins is blocked. Bump set the other side. This is Priest. She's blocked and roofed. Tali Hawkes next to Amber Igidi. And the reaction, once again, was highest volume.
Does Tali Hawkes know how to celebrate? Does somebody have to work on that with her or not?
I mean, it's like a firecracker. Just an explosion of excitement.
It's a pretty good pass in there.
Oh, and that one is sent straight down to the Terraflex by Priest.
Galvin put up a couple really good. Like Galvin knows Olivia Bennett put up some really good passes there off some pretty tough serves.
13 serving 11. Lang gonna go outside. Here is Wagner cross court and wide. And another point for USD. Riley Wagner in the negatives right now. Hitting negative 100 with two kills. The crowd gonna try to turn up the volume knob a bit. Tough serve again. Here's Igidi in the middle, dug up by Hoagland. Bump set Priest with the wind up. Good dig there by Lang. Bump set goes to Hawkes. And she smashes it.
little bit of extra mustard and ketchup on that one. She had a well-formed block she was facing, and there's the celebration. She said in the paper this morning, said, you know, I think one of the things I need to bring to this team is more energy. Well, she's doing that.
Oh, that was struck well there by Priest. And that's going to get San Diego to 15 first. The Torero service game has been trouble for Hawai'i here in set two. Welcome back. Rainbow Wahine Classic closing out tomorrow. Hawai'i taking on number 9 Oregon. Oregon with a pair of sweeps already to its ledger. Of course, it'll be an earlier match tomorrow. Per usual on Sunday, we'll go on the air at 4:30. Rainbow Warrior football team, strong showing, certainly against Vanderbilt, but some mistakes, some self-inflicted errors here or there really cost what could have possibly been a Hawai'i surprise for many. Road victory against an SEC opponent, but they fall one touchdown short. But certainly you'd have to say, compared to 63-10 last season against Vandy, a step in the right direction, right?
Yeah, for sure.
As Stoner lays into one again, this is the largest lead for San Diego here in set two. 16 serving 12.
Stoner having quite the night, 7 kills. No errors in 9 tries. He's hitting for huge numbers.
778. The average at the moment for Haley Stoner. And they've just been locked in from the service line. Here's Aijidi in the middle. It's Groundhog Day.
That time, at least San Diego, I think, got 1.5 blockers on him. Not quite enough, but Amber just is continuing to find a way to get around or through those blocks.
She had 14 kills over 5 sets last night. She's got 12 already here. We're in set 2. Perfect pass there. Outside, it's Priest. Unloads.
Oh, I love that set from Hoagland, too. She just fired that on a line. Stayed under the antenna, top of the antenna the whole time. See how low that is and fast it is. Tough to get out there and block that. Even Aijidi, with all of her foot speed, couldn't get there in time.
That's something that Jennifer Petrie wants, right? She wants them to speed it up, pull on the throttle as much as possible. But she says it's a work in progress because she is dealing with a group of lesser experienced setters, because that position was so locked up previously with Gabby Blossom, as Alexander is able to ricochet it off the block and down. Well, Hawai'i trying to fight here. A little past the midway mark of this second frame. It's a good bump set there from Edmonds. That one actually ricocheted off the net.
One of the most important things these liberos have got to do is bump set that ball well.
Outside, here's Beach off the fingertips of the block, dug up by Wagner, punched over by Lang. And then a block there in the middle by Evans. San Diego still with it. Here's Beach. Block slowed it down. Chance Hawai'i. Evans in the middle. Gets it home. Hawai'i within 2.
Told you Evans and Aijidi would get more sets tonight, but you know what? Didn't I say that? Or maybe you told me that. I got it mixed up.
You're fishing for compliments here already, C-Mac. It's so obvious.
I'm so glad that, we're seeing what we saw last week in the green-white scrimmage when Kennedy Evans was just awesome, hitting everything. Slides, quicks, blocking.
Here's Beach. Big wind-up that time, but she is stuffed. Kate Lang getting the gist of that one, jumping up next to Evans. 3 straight Rainbow Wahine points, and they're within 1 here in set 2.
I think Lang got most of it. She stayed true to form, staying on that right side, not leaning in too much. Took the line.
Here's Beach down the line and in. Again, that fast-paced offense. That's set to the outside off of the hands of Alex Hoagland. Gets there in a hurry.
A little tough for Kennedy Evans to get there. Actually didn't make a difference. It looked like Beach just went over Lang that time.
Langland slide to Evans.
Hey, you know what? You did say that Evans would probably get more sets here tonight.
And she is. And she's converting.
Spent 4 years, two full seasons at Utah, redshirted as a sophomore in 2019, was injured in 2021. Played in limited fashion last season, just 7 matches while still recovering from the injury. As Layla Blackwell gets another kill. San Diego has not missed a lot of serves, just 2 service errors. Now just 2 aces, but again, it's not really about the ace numbers. These serves have just been problematic for Hawaii throughout this second set. Good pass that time by Wagner. 2 blockers up against Alexander, and it doesn't matter.
Nice little misdirection by Kate Langner, kind of cutting toward the left side of the court, and just firing it back to the right. Caught the San Diego block a little bit off guard. Going to the front, setting back.
Alexander with the serve, and it's a good one. It's an ace! And we are knotted up here at 19 apiece.
Going to Petrus to call a timeout here. Slow down. Well, maybe she's not. Both coaches have their 2 timeouts left. We'll use them judiciously down the stretch here.
19 all. We start anew, but Alexander serves it long. Serve has just been flattening out a little bit on her here through the first couple of matches, but a couple of aces already. We saw 33 aces last season. But San Diego jumps ahead by 1. They get to the 20-point mark. Olivia Bennett with the serve. It's an ace right back at you. Off of the net. That's a heartbreaker if you're a Hawaii fan. San Diego now up 2 here in the second.
Watch for Robin on Motor call a timeout here.
She does.
Gather her forces.
So timeout Hawaii. We'll take a break as well. Toreros trying to close in on evening this match. Rainbow Wahine Classic wraps up tomorrow, and then next week it is USC, still currently of the Pac-12, coming out for a pair of matches. It'll be Thursday and Saturday, and we'll have that action for you. 21-19 San Diego out of the timeout. Lang goes middle to Evans, saved by Hoagland, but just for a moment. And Evans gets another big clutch kill. She has 5. She goes back to the bench in the rotation, and Amber Igidi comes back into the front row.
But Kennedy Evans in the second set, she's 4 for 5. No errors. Had a great run that last pass through the front row.
Yeah, 5 kills now for her, hitting 273. Blackwell blocked! Calm style! Amber Igidi, talk to the hand! And we're tied at 21!
Oh my goodness.
That was remarkable.
So athletic, and she reads so well. She knows how to move her hands. She knew that the only chance she had of taking away that cutback shot was to throw out one arm.
And there are some of those top-level plays in volleyball, right? You just bounce one straight down to the floor. That gets the crowd going. A stuff block, solo style. But the one-hand block might be...
Yeah. Best crowd pleaser?
That might be the creme de la creme, yeah, if you will. Let's send it over to Ryan. Ryan, what's up?
The one-handed block is something that Hawai'i is becoming used to. Of course, we saw it on the men's team. Amber Ajidi doing it right here. I got to tell you, after that play, the coaching staff erupted, giving all of themselves a high five. But Robin Amo really settling down her team, saying, hey, we got to finish this out. Really talking to her team about being aggressive offensively. She wants her players to grow up and grip. We saw a lot of tips happening last night. But tonight, Hawai'i, much more offensive. She's talking to her players, especially the freshman, Tally Hawkins, about using San Diego's hands and finding ways to chip around the block instead of necessarily trying to challenge it, going high hands and going through the seam. Back over to you guys.
Thanks a lot, Ryan. Yeah, hard to remember sometimes. Tally Hawkins, 21 years old, spent 2 years in the Israeli Army.
She's a freshman.
So there are still some of those freshman lessons that need to be learned.
Absolutely.
Despite her level of maturity. We're tied at 21. It's a race to four, C-Mac. Hawai'i leading this match, one set to none. Now they go into extras in the first, 27-25 to claim that one. Edmonds the serve out of the timeout. Right side, it's Stivrins off the block. Chance here for Hawai'i. Lang goes to Ajidi. The set was a little low, but she makes it work anyway. And Hawai'i leads 22-21.
Amber's got the golden touch tonight. Everything going her way, including tip shots. Kate Lang having a lot of confidence going to Amber, even from 10 feet off the net.
Edmonds, good serve. Outside, it's Priest, cross court and wide. No touch. Hawai'i up 2, 23-21, and Jennifer Petrie gonna call for a timeout. What a turnaround here. Hawai'i scoring four straight, sparked by the Kong block by Amber Ajidi.
This set has been mostly San Diego the whole time. Their serving's been exceptional. Looked like they were going to turn around and win the second set. And all of a sudden, Hawai'i roars back, starts serving better themselves, and gets up back up to tie it, and then they go to up two. This is a strange series of events here.
It kind of reminds you a little bit in reverse what transpired in set one. Remember, Hawai'i led by six in the first frame. San Diego came back. They had three serves for set one. Hawai'i ultimately able to win that 27-25. In this one, as you alluded to, San Diego seemed more or less in control. They led by as many as four, even getting to the 20-point mark first. And it just felt like, all right, San Diego poised to maybe even this thing up. But Hawai'i has surged here late in this frame.
Robin Amo's got to be happy with the way her team has served. Weathered the storm of the San Diego serves and started passing better. We've got Amber in front right now. There's a scoring machine right there to get two more points if they get a dig or two.
Look at those numbers.
That's crazy.
We're in set two, folks.
That's crazy. That's a night's worth of work. I think if San Diego gets a good pass here, they're going to go to their middle, Layla Blackwell, with a good pass. We'll see.
It is Talia Edmonds to serve. 23 serving 21. Gets it in. What a pass. Outside, Priest off the block and down. What a pass by Maddie Allen, laying out.
Give a lot of credit to Allen, too. That was one tough serve to pass up. It was moving a lot. It was diving at the end. She just hung in there and popped it up almost perfectly.
Second year with the Toreros, spent 2 years previously at BYU. Did Maddie Allen. Of the serve down the line. Hawai'i still up one. Outside, it's Wagner. Good up there by Bennett. The swing by Stivrins. It's a good one. Pinballed around. Two-handed over, free ball style. Advantage San Diego. Stivrins slowed down by the block. Dug up by Ikenaga. Amber! Lumber! And it's aloha ball for Hawai'i.
It's hammer time. Wow, what a night she's put together. 14 kills now, getting almost 600.
Hakas now to serve for set two. Outside, it's Priest, touch shot. Amber with the save. Hakas tried to set up Wagner, didn't get out there, so a free chance here for San Diego. Outside, it's Priest again, blocked back, she nudges it up. Bump set, it's gonna go to Stiverins. Hits it out, was there a touch? No touch, and Hawai'i rallies to take set two. 25-22. And with the crowd erupting, the Rainbow Wahine will have an opportunity to crack open the broom.
Intermission here at Simplify Arena, Stan Sheriff Center and Hawai'i. Up two sets to none on number 13, San Diego, 27-25 in the first and 25-22 in the second. Coming up next, the serve to start set number three.
Welcome back. Here are the Pizza Hut match statistics. All right, C-Mac, Hawai'i really pulling out the first two sets by the skin of their teeth, 27-25 and then 25-22, but doing a much better job offensively tonight.
It's all about the offense, the kill percentage, the big number here. San Diego hitting 60 points less than last night. They hit 250 last night, and Hawai'i hitting 130 points higher than last night. So the two offenses going in different directions.
Welcome back to Simplify Arena at Stan Sheriff Center. Next to Chris McLaughlin, I'm Kanoa Leahy. And really, the storyline starts with number three in the middle, Amber Aijidi. She has just gone bananas here in this match.
Yeah, she's really been special, doing it in all kinds of ways. Not just the quick set there in the middle. She gives a little tip shots as well. She's been doing a little block and a King Kong block with one hand. And, of course, she had that tight slide that I like. Not the wide slide, but the tight one really worked well.
So set three underway, Hawai'i up two sets to none, and an ace right out the gate here by Olivia Bennett.
This match far from over, by the way. This is the 13th ranked team in the country that Hawai'i's playing, and they're not going to give up easily and go home.
Yeah, you'd imagine Jennifer Petrie had a few things to say to her team as Bennett provides and then gets denied there by the Nets, so 1-1 here to start. But this is a prideful program. They suffered a sweep defeat last night against Oregon. You'd imagine Jennifer Petrie is not interested in allowing her team to be swept a second straight night.
Absolutely.
And you could see it in that swing by Blackwell. There was a little extra angst behind that one. And it's 2-1 here early on in set three for San Diego.
Blackwell picking up kill number five on the night. She's only got one error, hitting by 450. Having a good night compared to last night's 0-0-0.
Pass by Wagner. That's tight to the net. Little joust up there. Played off the ricochet by Lang. Here's Wagner. Took a little something off. Saved there by Stiverins. Now Priest. Slide to Aijidi. Had to traverse a long way. Stoner dug up by Hakas. Outside it's Wagner. Oh, and she pummels it.
Ronnie Wagner way overdue. Hitting negative all night long. Two kills, three errors. Now all of a sudden she's back to level playing field at 0-0-0, but I'm sure she's going to bring that up. She needs to be hitting around 250 every night if Hawaii's going to win.
Had 54 attempts last night. 13 swings so far in this one. Two serving two. That's Priest. Dug up by Wagner over the net and out. Well, whatever Jennifer Petrie said to her team between sets two and three, it seems as though they're swinging with much more ferocity here in the third, at least early on.
I would agree. Great swing by Priest there.
Jennifer Petrie, I mean, what a run. 25th season atop this program.
24 of the 25 gone to the NC2A. That's pretty good.
Incredible.
Pretty good record.
From behind the line, that's Stiverins. One hand save, Hakas. Outside, it's Alexander. She punishes that set. And we're tied at three. Obviously, Amber Aijidi having one of those nights, but Kaylin Alexander putting together quite the effort as well. 9 kills for her, hitting 333.
Here comes Kennedy Evans back into the front row. She had a great second set, 4 kills, no errors.
And Priest sends it long. Was there a touch? No touch called. It's going to be a point for Hawai'i, and I think Jennifer Petrie is going to challenge the touch. Again, the officiating crew, Wayne Lee, atop the ladder across the way. Randy Rubinall there in your screen. He's going to don the headset to review this. Matt Tsutsumi, Kevin Chun, the two line judges. So we enter into what has traditionally been the most difficult challenge to conclusively decipher. Touch, no touch.
Could have been a little finger there.
Yeah, that pinky finger of Kennedy Evans. I think even with the level of resolution we're working with here and frames per second, you could argue that you could see that contact there. But again,
hard to tell if I got bent back or not.
Only to a certain point, right? I think, yeah, I think I'm going to go out on a limb here, C-Mac. I'm going to say there was a touch.
Ooh, could have been the pinky.
What say you?
I got to go with you on this one. I think the pinky got bent back a little bit. Then again, this is the most difficult of all the replays. Seeing touches on the block is very, very difficult. Resolution just isn't as great as
most of these angles are not static cameras. They're moving cameras, and right. So it makes it a little more difficult from that standpoint as well. But you work with what you got. And Randy Rubinall taking a long look at this, and I think he's come to a decision. So we both on the record as saying that there was a touch.
Yeah, I think he's going to call touch. We'll see.
Let's see here. Oh, he's going to say inconclusive. And so the call will stand because there was not incontrovertible evidence to overturn.
So Jen Petrie down to one challenge.
Four serving three. Slide goes to Stoner, and she is stuffed. Alexander next to Evans, returning it to Sender. And the Manoa Roofing Company once again putting in work.
Kevin Alexander, nice shuffle move to the outside, and then just goes straight up.
That's 6 blocks now as a team for Hawai'i. Priest slowed down by the block. Lang goes middle. Evans had to just nudge it over. So Priest will try to time it on the high ball. Dug up by Aijidi. Lang going to go out to Alexander. Dug up over the net. Hawai'i will play it. Lang goes over on 2. Diving save by Allen. Touchdown by Evans. And it finally drops. Good effort on both sides of the net. The crowd in Manoa loves that. But Hawai'i gets the point. They really love that part.
And Evans picks up yet another kill. She's putting up some nice numbers tonight. Got to be happy for her with all the injuries she had to go through last year. Didn't get much playing time.
6 kills, 3 blocks for Evans. And then Aijidi short-armed just a smidge. Hawai'i up 2 here in set 3.
Aijidi hates to miss serve. You know why? She doesn't get to show off her defense.
That's right.
And it's really good defense. It's gotten better and better every single year.
And every single year we ask the same question of the coaches, right? Is Amber Aijidi going to play 6 rotations?
That's right.
And every year that answer has, as Wagner did not get it in, according to the line judge, but Kate Lang and company vehemently argue that that was in, and so Robin Amo is going to challenged the call, so it's going to be an in-out challenge here. But every year we ask the coaching staff about Amber playing six rotations, and every year they've gotten a little more coy in their response, right? Every year it's like, well, I mean, maybe. I don't think we're too far away from possibly seeing that at some point.
Yeah, yeah. I thought that ball was clearly out. I'm surprised that all five players in the court that saw it said, Coach, you got to challenge that. So there must be something to it. Oh, that's definitely in. Are you kidding me? That's way in.
I don't think we're going to get an inconclusive.
I think the line was too far away. I think it was too far away and couldn't see it. What
I don't think we're going to get an inconclusive on this one.
No. You think the linesman is too far away? That's the question.
Oh, yeah, that's in. Yeah,
that's way in.
That's in. Crowd reacting to some of the shenanigans on the big screen above. And they're definitely going to make some noise upon this decision. A successful challenge by Robin. She's all smiles. And Hawai'i up 3-7, serving 4. And Robin going to check on the rotation here for Hawai'i. Kate Lang will serve. Well, you got to appreciate that communication between the players and the bench.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And Lang sends it long.
And just before that, Robin, I think Robin Rowe turned to Kate and says, make sure you keep this in. We just got a favorable call. Make sure you keep this one.
Good pass there by Wagner. Evans in the middle. Chased down by Anna Jaworski, and then that is just smashed. Layla Blackwell, wow.
Layla Blackwell.
She had a big match last year in the Elite Eight round of the NCAA tournament. 14 kills, 583 percentage. It was a 5-set win over Stanford, which got San Diego to its first ever Final Four appearance.
That was a big win. I think Stanford was seeded maybe second or third.
Now Stoner to serve. Hawkus with the pass, gets the set on the outside, and crushes it.
Just her third kill of the night. She really needs to start, I think, contributing more to the offense. Like that, finding the seam and hitting through it and down.
Yeah, that was Tally at full extension there as Alexander serves it long. Haven't quite been able to make the adjustment. Seven serving 8. And here's Alex Hoagland from Berkeley, California, out of Bishop O'Dowd High School. Fourth year with the program, primarily used as a serving and defensive specialist in previous seasons. Now delivers an ace from the service line and is one of their primary setters here to start this 2023 year.
And that may have been an out ball as well.
And we're tied at 8. Peaks and valleys would be a way to describe the play, really on both sides of the net tonight.
Totally agree.
Chased down by Edmonds after the first touch by Wagner. Free chance for the Toreros. Middle, it is Blackwell with her 7th kill of the match, and San Diego leapfrogs ahead.
You know, in a good pass, the middles are going to get the ball pretty much on both sides of the net for Hawai'i and for San Diego. Pretty much anticipate that and be right 100% of the time.
Again, Hawai'i out of system. Wagner, two blockers up, is able to work it to her advantage. And that's an area where Hawai'i can certainly stand to achieve a little bit of improvement, right? The out-of-system swings, trying to be a little bit more terminal. They haven't necessarily established that go-to player under those circumstances.
Here's the third serve in a row out. They got to get better at that, too.
Yeah, that's
serve
another
ball on the court. Hard to score points, you know, by the way, when you serve it out. In fact, you're scoring a point for the other team every time you serve it out.
100% of the time.
100%
when you serve it out, you are not scoring for your team 100% of the time. The pass there, Ikenaga. Right side, it's Hakas. Dug up by Allen. Stivrin's off the block. Lang, you know who. Aijidi is dug up nicely by Bennett. Stivrin's again able to nudge it past the block. Just got a piece of the hands there. Another point for San Diego. It's 11 serving 9.
Smart play there by Stivrin. Remember, Stivrin's comes from pretty good volleyball lineage. Sister Lauren, two-time All-American at Nebraska.
Two blockers up on Wagner. She pumps it long. A little bit of an avoidant swing there. And it is San Diego by 3. Things starting to slip a little bit here at this mid-stage of the third. Overpass. Thank you very much, says Blackwell. Point San Diego. Toreros have just 3 service errors in this match. They have just consistently put the pressure on from the service line.
Absolutely. And the serves have been that go in have been tough.
And that one was one of those tweeners. Could have been an out ball.
Yep.
Priest dug up by Ikenaga. Bump set Lang, it's going to be Hakas, blocked and roofed. It was Blackwell jumping up next to Stivrin, 6-4 and 6-2 respectively. San Diego now leads by 5. That's the run that they're on, 5 straight points.
I think Robin Amo has not called timeout because she knows there's immediate timeout and one more point.
That one crawls over the net. And a center line violation called against Kate Lang, an ace for Maddie Allen. San Diego storming ahead here in the third. Welcome back. There you see a look at the Toreros down 0-2 here in this match. But they have once again been able to snag a good grip here on this third frame. Leading by 6. Remember, they were up by 4 in the second set. Seemed to be in control, and Hawai'i was able to mount a comeback. But the expression there on the face of head coach Robin Amo kind of says it all. It's a 6-0 run here for San Diego. And Hawai'i has struggled in stretches handling the Torero serves. Wagner off the block, covered by Lang. Aijidi back bump set goes over the net, and it's dunked down by Priest. And this thing is getting away from Hawai'i in a hurry. That's now 7 straight points for USD.
Well, give all the credit to USD. I'm telling you, their tough serving is causing Hawai'i's passers all kinds of problems.
And just consistent. I mean, they're getting everyone in. Aijidi off the block. They're starting to key on her. Blackwell in the middle, good save there, Lang. Bump set, Hakas, 2 blockers against her, tried to go cross court, misses wide. It is now 17-9 in favor of San Diego. Hawai'i buffering here in the third. Robin Amo signaling for a timeout. A head-to-head stat line. Couple of middles battling. Layla Blackwell, 8 kills, hitting 583. Amber Aijidi, 14 kills, hitting 520. But it's been pretty much all Toreros here in the third. Again, those serves just tickling the tape, causing even more difficulty for Hawai'i passers. But Wagner goes off the block and into the pin, and that ends an 8-0 San Diego run. A much-needed point for Hawai'i.
Fair to give an MVP to San Diego tonight right now? All their servers. They've really been good.
Well, that pass off the mark, and that's an ace. Tally Hawkins. That's the fourth ace of the match for Hawai'i. She had an ace last night as well. 11 serving 17, but you're right. It's not the most overpowering array of serves from San Diego, but they're tricky.
Yeah.
And they just seem to be so consistent with it, always getting it in play, always forcing the passers to have to make a play. Wagner misses wide.
She had a wide open corner, wide open line. That ball's got to be kept in play.
Six kills for Riley Wagner. Hitting .050. Here's Igidi on the slide, and that goes long. Was there a touch? No touch. And at what point do you start to maybe think, all right, this set isn't for us? Maybe we start thinking about set four.
Yeah, I remember Al Skates on the men's side. If the set was going like this, he would empty the bench entirely and rest all the starters for the following set. He was famous for doing that.
Yeah, we've seen much stranger things and seen comebacks from distances even greater than this.
Dolly scoring was really tough to make large comebacks,
yeah,
in general.
And the out serve's not helping. Hawai'i now with nine service errors compared to just four for San Diego. Hawai'i had 13 service errors last night. It's not always the amount as much as maybe the timing.
Of them.
Here's Alexander. Caught that one flush.
When she gets the right set, the right place, she's a good approach. She can be a terminator. She can go line, she can go angle, she can go wide fan. That one, I think she just hits in the seam and just buries it.
Got some attendance numbers. 5,826 tickets issued through the turnstile. 4,576 in the building tonight. Wagner from behind the line, dug up by Allen. And a free ball coming over the net. Can Hawai'i take advantage? Here's Alexander. Popped straight up in the air by Bennett. Priest dug up by Hawkins. Alexander, another crack at it. Dug up again by Bennett. Priest again blocked the cover there by Allen. Priest a third time blocked in a row. They just would not let her pass.
Oh my, Priest was taking good swings. Hoagland giving her good sets. Boy, block just kept hanging in there. Perseverance won out.
14 serving 20. Middle set, it's Stoner, well placed. How about the court vision there by Haley Stoner? Just one hitting error all night. That's her eighth kill.
Yeah, the middles have been tough. Blackwell and Stoner with, I think, eight kills apiece. Both hitting for high percentage, 583 and 500. Very different from last night's 0-0-0 and 0-6-2. What a turnaround.
Yeah, that's exactly what Jennifer Petrie told us. And our middles, they're our veterans,
yep,
they're our leaders. As they go, we'll go, in essence. And they're going here tonight. And how about that, an out serve by San Diego?
That's a rarity.
So 15 serving 21. This thing not pow here yet in the third. But a big time uphill climb here for Hawai'i if they are to still make a set of it. Good serve there. It's Beach. Haven't called her name in a little while. Over on two goes the setter, Hoagland. Bump set goes to Hawkins. Off the block and out. Hawai'i within five. Crowd starting to ramp up the noise just a bit.
I think if nothing else, I think Robin Amo would love to see a strong finish here in the third. Get some few things straightened out defensively and offensively going into the fourth. a possible fourth.
Get a little momentum at the very least, if at all possible. Stoner blocked and roped. Kennedy Evans in the middle of the action. And a timeout taken by San Diego. Hawai'i with. Oh, what a gift it would be if Hawai'i in front of the home fans could somehow turn what was an 8-point deficit into a competitive close to this third set. They have trimmed that in half, in essence. Guess you could call that Christmas in August if that were to happen. Free chance here for Hawai'i. Lang goes outside. Alexander, was there a touch? No touch, goes out. And a golden opportunity for Hawai'i to cut further into the lead. Goes away.
Wow, they had a great swing there. Kayla just biting off a little more than she can chew of that line.
Evans able to plug it through the block. Evans is starting to get a little bit of the Amber treatment as far as the set selection is concerned,
she
don't
is.
You think?
She's getting a lot of treatment, a lot of love there. See Hawkins there next to her, struggling offensively, only 4 kills and 3 errors, but you know what? She leads the team in digs right now. She's got 11.
Talia Edmonds not far behind her with 9. Beach is able to go through the block and down. Nemo Beach, 8 kills for her. Percentage has dropped a little bit. Hit 400, remember, last night against Oregon, but she's been there when they've needed her in different moments here in this match. Just a freshman, an absolutely bright future.
Absolutely.
Good pass there by Wagner. Hawkins, the dink did not clear the net. And it's Aloha ball for San Diego. Hawai'i seemed to be making a bit of a push. And Robin Amo on Aloha ball gonna signal a timeout here, C-Mac. We'll take a break as well. It's San Diego by a half dozen. Welcome back. Timeout taken by Robin Amo on Aloha ball here for San Diego. Wanting to still deliver a message to her team. On the precipice of giving up this set. Up 2-0, however. San Diego just trying to avoid the sweep. Evans couldn't get it down. Now Beach will get a swing at it. Two-hand save there, Edmonds. Here's Wagner, tip shot. Beach had it sniffed out. Right side, that's Stivrins. Diving save, Edmonds. Touchdown from above the tape, though, by Stivrins. And San Diego responds after going down 0-2. 25-18. Hawai'i hits .086 in the third. Set four coming up.
Welcome back. You gotta appreciate the resourcefulness of San Diego, despite being down 0-2 here in this match. Put together a really strong showing in that third set. Didn't necessarily hit an extremely high number, just 194 percentage-wise as a squad, but served tough, put Hawai'i into problematic situations. Rainbow Wahine hit .086 in the third, and San Diego able to bounce back 25-18. They avoid the sweep, and they seem to clearly have the momentum on their side here going into the fourth.
That's correct. Come on, you know, Hawai'i only hit 8%, .086. In that set, and it was mostly due to great San Diego serving and some sketchy Hawai'i passing, and then a few, I thought, ill-chosen attack swings that could have been better. All that adds up to, you know, a 25-18 runaway by San Diego. We'll see what happens in the fourth set here and see if Hawai'i can recapture some of that momentum they had in the first two sets.
It'll be Talia Edmonds to serve. Hawai'i still with the advantage up 2-1. Outside, Priest able to touch it down for the first point here in set four. A push dink there by Kylie Priest. Coming from a family of athletes, brothers Jake and Micah, both able to play baseball in the professional ranks in the minors.
I was just going to say that, by the way.
Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to.
Once again, you stole my line. In a 2 hour and 38 second match last night, I don't think we stepped on each other's toes, but that definitely was a step on toe moment. Hey. I was just going to say that.
Hey, great minds think alike. What are you going to do? Serve goes long. Next time, just give me an elbow, all right?
A rare error. Hawaii's got 9 serving errors. That's only San Diego's 6th error, and they've got 6 aces to go along with it.
So 1-1 here in the 4th. Middle set, that's Stoner. How about that layout save over the net by Edmonds? Right side, Stiverins off the block. It crawls over onto the Hawai'i side. Bump set goes to Wagner. Soft touches it deep. Going to be played back by the Toreros. Stoner is blocked by Igidi. Outside it's Priest, dug up by Edmonds, chased down by Hawkes. And a free chance once again for San Diego. Priest, a blasty blast, wrist away, very tough angle. And San Diego jumps back up.
Priest has had more swings than any other Torero tonight. Her arm is getting warmed up, I guess, right now. She's bringing some major heat.
10 kills on 33 swings, 152. Stiverins the serve, that's an out ball.
Neither side really willing to make many lineup changes, Kanoa. Kind of interesting.
San Diego now out of system. Stiverins can slap it over. Chance here for Hawai'i. Lang goes to Alexander, and she goes through that Torero block for a Hawai'i point. Yeah, getting to what you were referencing there, C-Mac. Sometimes, whether or not coaches decide to pull starters off the floor if they're down big in a set, you might see at least one substitution here or there, get some game time, game experience, so to speak, for some of the other players on the roster. And one of the players we have yet to see here this opening weekend is Paula Gershing, the transfer from Youngstown State, who was Youngstown State's first ever ABCA All-American honorable mention last year. She is a 6'2 junior, has been dealing with a couple of little bumps and bruises throughout training camp and practice, but that said, by all accounts, she is a baller. We have yet to see her out there here this weekend. Maybe that was an opportunity potentially just to get her a couple of reps.
Yeah, I think in the third set runaway, I think it might have been an opportunity, but maybe she's gonna earn her time this week in practice.
Well, Kaylin Alexander bringing the thunder.
Alexander travels through the front row with Amber Igidi, and right now Alexander's starting to light it up, taking a lot of pressure off Amber. And also, Amber's had so much attention tonight. Kaylin Alexander tends to get split blocks, yeah, now, or even no block.
Now Amber and Kaylin with the same amount of attempts, 26 apiece. Here's Beach, 2 blockers up, she's blocked back. Good cover there by Allen. Beach a second time, dug up by Amber. But it finds its way into the hands of Jennifer Petrie, the head coach for San Diego. You know, she had a pretty interesting experience in the offseason. In fact, back in April, hey, look, this USD season that they put together last year was a big deal in that area. And so she was actually invited and granted an opportunity to throw out the first pitch at a Padres game.
Wow.
That ball bump set. Alexander. Oh, she is in her bag at the moment. That's 13 kills for her. She's up near 300.
She's heating up.
And
Yeah, Jennifer Petrie throwing out the first pitch before
was
the Padres
game. Was it a strike or what? Did you ask her?
She said she got it there. She said she got it there. She said the best part of it was she had the entire team, all the players standing behind her right there on the mound.
Oh, what an effort by Wagner to keep it alive. Can Hawai'i return it? No, they cannot.
But the crowd applauds the effort anyway. Here's some video of it. This is, again, back in April.
Please welcome the
she said it was one of the more nerve-wracking experiences of her life. Said that the San Diego baseball staff actually led her onto the practice field for a couple of practice throws here before the big day. Let's take a look. She got it there.
She did get it there. All right.
Oh, yeah. I mean, compared to some of the first pitches that are out there on the internet, that was pretty darn good.
Remember, she was at William & Mary. She was, oh, wow. Alexander. Woo-hoo. She is lighting up big time. When she was at William & Mary, she was actually two times player of the year in that conference. So she's got game.
Kaylin Alexander got game as well. 14 kills, hitting .321. And she has been a go-to force for Hawai'i so far in this fourth set. And then forces the overpass. And Hawai'i benefits by going up two. Riley Wagner putting the finishing touches on that one.
Jen Petrie's going to watch this score very carefully and not let the Rainbow Wahine get too far ahead. She wants to keep this difference here as small as she can. Another tough serve by Alexander.
Outside, it's Stivrins, dinks it over the block, and it drops. And that's a play that will drive Robin Amo crazy. She does not like seeing those tip shots hit the floor.
Well, in general, she doesn't want to see any ball hit the floor.
Yeah. See, talking to Kaylin Alexander there. Alexander with a good little series there at the service line. Here's Olivia Bennett. She's been tough from the service line. Good pass that time by Wagner. Gets the set on the outside. And a little extra oomph behind it.
And if Raleigh brings her percentage up, Hawkins brings hers up, and Alexander brings hers up, it bodes well for Hawaii's fortunes. Because clearly, Kennedy Evans and Amber Igeti have carried most of the load most of the night.
Oh, that's a tough serve there by Edmonds. Outside, Priest blocked back. Going to be Priest a second time. Dug up by Edmonds, goes over the net. The swing there by Blackwell. Hawai'i keeps it alive. Igeti sets up Wagner, but she hits it into the net.
Set just a little bit low. Riley Wagner just could not quite get there. And then her shot selection there. She tried to wipe it off the right hand of the outside blocker, but just a little too low.
Good pass that time, Ike Naga, to set a little low to Igeti, and they're starting to really load up on Igeti in the middle now. They had two blockers there in the area.
Who got most of it? As usual, Haley Stoner.
So we're tied at 8. Overpass. Advantage Torero. Stivrins dug up on one knee that time by Lang. And then Hawkins is roofed. This is a Torero's team that last year was 7th in the NCAA in blocks. Averaged 2.74 per set. They only had one block last night against Oregon, but my, how things have changed here tonight.
Yeah, they got out blocked 13-1 last night. Tonight, a different story.
Three straight points for San Diego.
You've got 9 blocks on the night now. Hawaii's got 8. And they both have 8.
Yeah, both with 8. Hawkins able to thread the needle and lets out a roar in the aftermath.
Oh, nice back set. Nelson split block there. They're paying a lot of attention again to Amber Igeti.
This fourth set fitting to be a battle here, C-Mac. We've already been tied 7 times. Priest dinks it over. Lang goes to Wagner. Tip shot drops.
It's like she was out on the sand.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. I loved it when she played beach volleyball last spring. I thought it really helped her game, helped her passing, helped her create shots like that. See the open court.
Third lead change here in this fourth set as Hawai'i jumps in front. Hawkus with the serve. Just got over the twine. Priest blasts it wide. Was there a touch? No touch. And Hawai'i up two.
Priest took a healthy swing at that one, that's for sure. I think she felt like the set was a good one. She was going to catch a piece of the block at least, and it didn't happen.
That was a big difference from what we saw between sets two and three, right? Coming out of that intermission, the San Diego hitters seem to be swinging with so much more effort. Just like that by Wagner. And Hawai'i goes up by three here in set four. They've scored four in a row.
Good scramble on defense, and then Riley Wagner finds the hole in the block there, catches a little bit of the middle blocker's hands, Stoner.
Good pass that time. Right side, it's Stivrins down the line, and it bounces right in front of Talia Edmonds.
That was nasty. That was downright nasty. Her cross court was taken away. She says, okay, fine, I'm going to rip it down the line. And she did with velocity and authority.
Amber Stivrin's sister Lauren was a two-time All-American middle blocker at Nebraska. That set a little high, forced Aijida to hang. Now Priest is blocked. They're going to go back to Priest. And she gets it by the double block of Lang and Aijida.
No approach, standing jump. No run out at all, but a great arm swing and a pretty good set right there. Just a step close and hammer.
Just went right between the wickets. Lang gonna go out to Wagner. Dinks it over. Now off of one leg, Stoner, a little awkward there, the connection. Not quite on the mark there between Hovland and Stoner, and it results in the freebie for Hawai'i. So 13 serving 11. And that's an ace! San Diego thought it was going long, but it curls in.
A dive at the last second there. Brilliant serve.
The fifth ace of the night for Hawai'i, and how about the third ace of the night for Riley Wagner?
Yeah, she can put a lot of heat and a lot of movement on the ball, like a knuckleball.
Stoner blocked back. Outside it's Priest, the tip shot. Alexander on it. Here's Aijida off the block and down. Hawai'i gets to 15 here in set four. And a timeout. The crowd drinking it in.
Takes on the University of Oregon Ducks to close out the Hawaiian Airlines Rainbow Wahine Classic. Rainbow Wahine Volleyball on OC16. Exclusively on Spectrum.
Welcome back. It's Hawai'i up two sets to one and up by four here in set four. They've scored three straight. In fact, you can expand that to a 7-2 overall run here right now being experienced by the Rainbow Wahine.
You know, they're serving better. They're putting San Diego into some passing difficulty. San Diego's not been able to get their middles as involved as they would like. So they'd love to have more balls go to Blackwell and Stoner, as many as they can.
San Diego leads the all-time series between these two teams 5-4. They won the last two, including the sweep in last year's Texas A&M Invitational. But what you won the last meeting in Honolulu, however, 3-0, if you remember, second round of the 2019 NCAA tournament. Wagner going to the near side. Priest is blocked back. Touch shot by Stoner. Good sliding save. Edmonds step out. Aijida. Oh, what a save in the back row by Bennett. Aijidi again through the block. One hand up by Hoagland. Bennett keeping it alive, layout style. Hawai'i again on the attack. Here's Alexander laying the smackdown.
And getting a big time hug from Hawkins. How about that celebration? But I'll tell you, watch this swing right here. Kaylin Alexander just bringing major heat tonight, especially in set. This set here. Look at a hug from Hawkins. She is a celebrator. Pass off the net.
Priest blocked and roofed. Access denied. Amber Aijidi getting most of that one. And a timeout taken by San Diego. The recipe that was working for the Toreros so well in set three now being applied from the Hawai'i side. Serving tough and blocking tough. Well, Amber Aijidi was the story early for Hawai'i, but Kaylin Alexander has come on strong here now. 15 kills, hitting 345, C-Man.
When she gets through the front row with Amber Aijidi, she's getting a lot of one-on-one blocking. 15 kills, 5 errors. She's having a big, big night, hitting 345.
Also a couple of digs, a service ace, 3 blocks. Able to lift some of the load off of the shoulders of Amber Aijidi. 17 serving 11 out of the timeout. Another good serve by Wagner. And it's knuckled over the net. So Hawai'i will play it back. Here's Alexander. What a dig there by Allen. Touched over by Stone. Layout save by Hawkins. But a free chance here for San Diego. Stoner in the middle. Straight down.
Amber Aijidi turned away from the net, put her hands over her face, went, I knew she was going there. Why didn't I take away that cutback?
So 12 serving 17. And what we have learned here throughout this match so far this evening, no lead has been safe. Alexander going to try to time it and hits it into the twine. 13 serving 17.
Alabama Moe's got 2 timeouts to use. I would use one right here, actually, to calm things down. If not, then the next serve for sure if they lose the point.
Rang going to go reverse field against this defense with Amber Aijidi off of 1 foot. Couldn't get it down. She digs up the beach swing, though. Tip shot by Stoner, fielded by Amber. They go slide to Amber, and she drops it.
Well, she was mad she didn't convert on the other one, and she's mad that she overpassed. So it was all about atonement at that point.
She got it started in that transition and then ended it. And now she's behind the service line, 18 serving 13.
Tough 7 points to get to 25, I'll tell you.
Good pass there by Priest. Tip shot by Annika Hester. And Hawai'i wasn't able to field it. Annika Hester played just one set last night against Oregon. Got the start tonight. We haven't seen much of her, though, since early on in this match.
She's only played that first set, and that was it. 6-4. Nice blocking sub at this point.
14 serving 18. Good pass that time by Wagner. Slide goes to Evans. Sniffed out by Stoner. And again, it's Hester. The dig, though, by Wagner. Alexander dug up over the net. And then over on two, Kate Lang calls her own number at the most opportune time.
Could not have picked a better time to call her own number. San Diego's defense was back, dug in, waiting for the quick set in the middle.
Even
Kate Lang, who oftentimes a little more soft-spoken than some of the other Rainbow Wahine players. Even she let out a scream after that point. I'm not sure what the call is here. They've actually given the side and the point to San Diego. Slide goes to Evans, and Hawai'i gets it back. So they actually called it a back row attack against Kate Lang.
Could have been. Kate Lang was front row. When she put that ball over, she was front row. I'm not sure why they called that.
Oh, I think the call was earlier in the sequence. It was Talia Edmonds who set with her hands in front of the 3-meter line.
And then Kate converted.
There you go. Here's Beach against two blockers, able to get it down. So let's take a look. Yeah, so that was a little puzzling as they made the late change there on the score. But there's Talia Edmonds in front of the line. And because Kate Lang went over, it was basically an illegal set by the libero.
Exactly. They can only use their hands to pass the ball up, but it can't be a set where somebody's going to convert it into an attack. That's why you see the libero's always bumping.
Right side, it's Alexander. Oh, what a dig back over the net by Allen. The other way, Hawkins, the tip, drops! And a subdued reaction that time by Tali Hawkins.
You know why? I think she wants the get these last 5 points in a hurry, number one. Number two, she knows that she's got to pull a bigger load offensively and not make so many offensive mistakes. And, you know, tonight, you know, she's hitting 0-48 on the night. That's she just got off a 5-5-5-0-0-0 number. And I think she's that's why she's being so subdued.
And Alexander serves it out. Hawkins does have 13 digs. Hawai'i is led by Talia Edmonds, who has 15. Another double-double performance by Riley Wagner, by the way. 10 kills, 10 digs. She had 13 kills, 12 digs last night against Northwestern. But this thing is far from power.
Oh, for sure.
Bennett, that serve, just nibbling at the net. Wagner from off the net, dug up there by Allen. It's going to be a free ball coming over. Can Hawai'i make it count? Lang, backside, Hawkins, the tip does not clear the net. A free ball transition, and Hawai'i couldn't convert. And Robin Amo is going to signal for a timeout. Oh, those moments late in a set, late in a match. They can come back, and they can haunt you. Welcome back. Well, Hawai'i was flexing earlier in this fourth set, led by as many as six. But then San Diego able to find some traction. They had the flex cam on during the timeout. And a little too much from the service line by Olivia Bennett, and Hawai'i gets gifted a very important point here at this juncture of the fourth set.
That's huge. After a timeout, Hawai'i reeling a little bit. I think they'll take the gift, won't they?
Oh, yeah. Talia Edmonds to serve. It's a good one. Forces the overpass. OIGD had a notion. She plays it. They go outside the Wagner. Tip shot. Easy pickings there for Priest. Right side, Stivrins. Her tip. Diving save, Edmonds. Bump set, Wagner with two blockers up. It's dug up over the net by Hoagland. It'll stay on the San Diego side. Stivrins, the quick reset. Two-hand save there, Edmonds. Wagner able to soft touch it over. Middle set, and it is Blackwell. Paintbrushes it. Pancake save, Lang. Hawkins is blocked. And in the end, when the dust clears, Toreros get the point.
Wow. Both sides had swings. They had chances to get that point. Oh, look at that great save by Lang, keeping that rally alive. And Hawkins hitting right into the meat of the block.
Another opportunity for Hawai'i. Seemed to have the advantage in that exchange. but they couldn't cash it in. 19 serving 21. That's a good pass there. Here's Aijidi. Yes, she can. 17 kills for Amber.
I think you're a good pass the rest of the night that goes up where it's Aijidi settable. She'll get it.
Yeah. It doesn't matter how many blockers are waiting for her. Just go to Amber. Outside, Priest. Oh, a little chin music there for Edmonds. Almost conjured up the save. So Leah Edmonds up to 17 digs here in this match. Good work on the other side by the Torero libero, Maddie Allen, who also is up there in digs. She's got 16. 20 serving 22. They run the slide. It's Amber. And she gets it down again.
That was a tough set. A little risky, but Amber makes every set look good, doesn't she?
Amber intent on dragging her team across the finish line here. They are 2 points away. 18 kills for Aijidi.
Now she's got Alexander with her in the front row. Pretty good rotation here for Hawaii.
Riley Wagner, who has served tough here in this match.
6-4 Hester back in the front row.
Another good serve. Bump set outside. Priest hits it long, but there was a touch. Notice the change at the setter spot. Ani Evans, number 10 out there now for San Diego. 21 serving 23. Oh, these last 2 points feel like they're 20. Out serve! Aloha ball for Hawaii!
And almost 5,000 fans stand as one.
A timeout taken by Jennifer Petrie. We will keep it here. Some of the fans will decide to sit down, take a little load off here during the timeout. Some will remain standing, but Hawaii 1 point away from knocking off the 13th ranked team in the country. And it would set up, if they can close the deal, a true championship match in this tournament tomorrow against number 9 Oregon. Let's send it over to Ryan. What's up?
Hey, thanks, Kunal. Well, here on the Hawaii sideline, of course, Robin Amol just really trying to get her team to focus on this last point. Amber Aijidi behind the service line, who's had runs in the past. Right now, they're spending a lot of time talking to Kennedy Evans, the other middle now that is rotated to the front row, about what to expect offensively. They're hoping to get San Diego out of system and force them to go high to the pin, recognizing that that may be their best shot here. So really looking for a tough serve by Amber here in the, on this match point, and spending a lot of time talking to their other middle blocker about where to go. Back over to you guys.
Thanks a lot, Ryan.
I was going to say that at this juncture, I'm surprised that Amber doesn't get subbed out for, you know, another small to get a dig. But Amber plays some pretty good defense, so they trust her. And it's actually hard to put somebody in, you know, who hasn't played all night too. But
and Amber has actually become a pretty effective server as well.
Exactly. Yeah.
You see the Maui decals on the left arm sleeve of the Wahine players. They will be dedicating this season, as all of the University of Hawaii sports teams will, to the recovery effort on the island of Maui. And we send our love and our prayers and our aloha to everyone over there. The Wahine trying to finish the deal. Aloha ball for the match. Middle, it's Stoner. One hand sliding save. Hawkins, it's set over two hand style by Aijidi. Middle set, Stoner off the block of Evans and down. And it's not over yet.
You knew that on good passes it was going to go to Stoner for sure. Now she's out, but rotating to the front.
And Stoner back to serve with 10 kills now.
Comes Blackwell to the front.
It remains Aloha ball.
Well, that could have been out ball.
From the back row, Wagner. Dug up by Stoner. What a dig. Middle set, Blackwell blocked and roofed. Kennedy Evans ends it. And the Rainbow Wahine take down nationally ranked San Diego in four. And open the 2023 season with a 2-0 record.
What a match. San Diego played better tonight. Hawai'i played better tonight. We saw some pretty darn good volleyball. Two coaches right there who really respect each other a lot. There's like Leo Baxter, he's the one that was the scouting report. And Ambry Jeannie, what a night she had. Wow. 18 kills, only three errors. It's a mere 417. She's something special.
Bank of Hawai'i presents the players of the match. Let's take a look for San Diego. Layla Blackwell had 9 kills, hit 500, and also had a handful of blocks. But it was the Amber Igidi show, really, throughout this match, certainly through the first two sets. 18 kills, finished 417, 4 blocks, and 8 digs. Got to give a nod to the double-double performance of Riley Wagner, 10 kills, 10 digs. How about 17 digs for Talia Edmonds? And Tali Hakus, who didn't necessarily have the same kind of offensive effectiveness as she did last night. 6 kills, hit negative, but she had 14 digs coming up big defensively for Hawai'i in a lot of serious spots. Let's send it over to Scott Robbs.
Hey, thanks a lot, Kanoa. Well, Coach, another migraine-inducing match for you and another win. And this was a big win over a top 10 or top 15 team.
Yeah, Jen always has these girls playing good. We love playing them, good staff, good players, athletic.
I really like the way Kennedy Evans played tonight. We saw her offensively and defensively. She looked pretty good.
We got the middles involved today. Yeah. Kate said a good game. I think that just a small lapse with 15 errors in that like third set. I count only the errors. 15 errors in that third set. We turned those errors into points. It's us. So.
All right, tomorrow night it sets up a true championship match, yourselves and Oregon. I don't know how much you've had a chance to watch Oregon, but they've looked pretty good. What are your thoughts?
They look good. They look big, in tune. But I think it's going to be a great match. Hopefully the girls come out and play.
Thanks, Robin.
See you guys tomorrow.
Good all.
Thanks a lot, Scott. It is going to be a challenge. It could possibly be an epic battle tomorrow night against number 9 Oregon. C-Mac, Hawai'i gets the win in 4. I'll give you the final word here.
I think it's great that they get to the final match. They're 2-0 playing for a true championship. And you know, Kanoa, they better bring their track shoes tomorrow because Oregon sets about as fast an offense as there is in the country. Really entertaining to watch. They're big, they're strong, well-coached. It'll be a fun match.
I see what you did there. Track shoes, Oregon, Phil Knight. I see what you're doing over here, C-Mac. We're playing checkers. You're playing chess all the way. Hawai'i gets the win. They're off to a 2-0 start here in 2023. San Diego falls to 0-2. Don't forget about the post-game show. They got a lot to break down, including the performance of Kennedy Evans and Kaylin Alexander. But for now, for C-Mac, Chris McLaughlin, I'm Kanoa Leahy. Maui, we love you. We bid you aloha from Manoa.
San Diego start off with the center for the Toreros, Alex Hoagland, who did a nice job of distributing the volleyball around the court for her fellow teammates as she helped lead San Diego to a 196 hitting percentage along with 38 assists. On the Hawai'i side, Kaylin Alexander took a step up here tonight. Alexander, the big right-hand kill, 15 kills, hit 273, picked up a service ace even in on 3 blocks for the sophomore. How about Riley Wagner, one of the veteran leaders on this team? Steady Eddie, as Lisa Strand likes to call her. She was 10 kills tonight. She had 3 service aces, 10 digs. I mean, she did a little bit of everything. She's kind of like that Swiss Army knife, if you will, on the floor for Hawai'i. And always, Amber Igidi's going to probably be in the highlights, and why not? She went off in the first set. She had 8 of her 18 kills in that first set. She finished with 18 kills, hit 417, threw in 8 digs and 4 blocks as Hawai'i knocks off number 13 San Diego in 4.
From Spectrum Sports, it's the Hawai'i Honda Dealers post-game show.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for sneaking around. Scott, Lisa, Ryan. Hawai'i goes to 2-0 in 2023 with a four-set victory over number 13 San Diego. And it's early. It's only the second match of the season. But how big a win do you think this is? Or do we have to wait till later for early in the season for this team?
Well, I think that this is a big win, again, for the program, going up against a team that will do well in the WCC, a team that is could continue to get ranks or votes in the top 25. But again, I think overall it's good for Hawaii's morale, knowing that they can beat ranked teams. I mean, this is a program who in recent years has struggled to pick up wins against ranked teams. So regardless of where San Diego falls at the time, the fact that Hawai'i beats a number 13 ranked team only bodes well for the direction of the program.
I agree. I mean, a big win for them as well as for San Diego. I mean, total battle on both sides, but we saw San Diego last night. We saw them tonight. Definitely improved from last night, but they're still making a lot of adjustments. It's still early, and Hawai'i really came out to battle tonight.
All right, let's take a look at the final numbers from this one. Hawai'i winning in four over San Diego. Hawai'i hitting a little bit better than last year. They hit in the 100s. They hit 220. 65 digs. Overall, what do you guys see, Ryan?
Well, again, a number that kind of stands out is that blocks. Hawai'i, 18 blocks on the night. This is turning into a very defensive-minded team. Not only
well, I don't think that's right. It's ten, it should be
it's
10
like 10 blocks.
Blocks,
correct.
Yeah, and San Diego should
I
have 9.
I was going to say, 18.
That jumped out at him.
But 10 blocks, still, I think Hawai'i showing that they can provide defensive support, not only behind in the backcourt, but also at the net. But the 220 is a positive improvement in that hitting percentage.
And along those lines, it's really necessary to, when you have blocks, if they're not blocking, then 65 digs, that's a lot of digs. So they're channel blocking really well.
You know, Amber Igita gets all the attention, and rightfully so, but you know, we got a chance to see what Kennedy Evans is capable of doing. Of course, barely played last year after transferring from Utah, where she sat out the year before because of injury. I thought tonight was kind of a coming out party for her.
I agree. You know what? She does a lot of little things that go unnoticed, and she's filling her role. She's a total role player. She gets her hands on a lot of balls. They don't set her a lot, but she has a high hitting percentage. I think she hit in the 300s the last two nights. She's really not super dynamic. The ball's not going to go straight down, but she does a lot of little things for the team.
And I think, of course, she came up with that crucial block to end the match, but she has a very good, you can tell she has experience. She reads well. She can move laterally well, and she also can hit behind off of one foot. So I think she provides some depth in Hawai'i's offense from the middle, but also the fact that she can get up as quickly as she can in transition.
What aspects of the game tonight did you see where Hawai'i improved from last night?
Well, ball control overall, I thought they played much better job. You know, we saw at times that they did struggle, but for the most part, they were able to stay in system, and I liked how more aggressive they were. Yes, there were a few tips here and there, but you could tell players like Caitlin Alexander really were going after it and just being a little bit more terminal when hitting.
And I think from the service line, they started with a lot of pressure on San Diego. Riley Wagner just came out bombing balls, and everybody else did as well. But they put a lot of pressure on San Diego to have to pass well, because knowing that San Diego's middles were their go-to girls, if they could get them out of system, they would be ahead of the game.
How about your favorite Steady Eddie, Riley Wagner? Her hitting percentage not great, and it typically isn't because of her role. But how about the three service aces that she served up tonight? Those were very huge aces.
Well, they started strong. That's the difference between last night and last night and tonight. Last night was a slow start. Tonight they got out of the gate early, and they put the pressure on, and they stayed, especially in that last game. They really put a lot of pressure on San Diego.
Well, I think one of the things that Hawai'i can maybe improve on is just minimizing some of the errors. We heard Robin say 15 errors in set number three is why they lost that set. And we saw some of that coming from behind the service line. But I think one of the things that Hawai'i has become more comfortable doing is putting on the pressure from behind the service line, especially when they're serving in their home gym. Some of these servers are really taking chances. I mean, the ball is barely clearing the tape out for some of these servers. So you can tell that they have experience serving in this environment and are confident going and serving aggressively here.
You agree?
I think it all starts from the service line, to tell you the truth.
Yeah, serve and passing in Hawai'i was probably better serving, and their passing had improved much. All righty, we'll take a break, but when we come back, one of the standouts from tonight's match will join us here in the corner. And welcome back to the corner, where Hawai'i knocks off number 13 San Diego in four here tonight. to go 2-0 on the season. Kaylin Alexander right there, one of the leaders for Hawaii with 15 kills here tonight. She joins us in the corner. First off, congratulations.
Thank you.
The last couple of nights have been long matches. I looked at the time. This match was only 10 minutes shorter than last night.
Okay. You know? How long was Northwestern's?
2:38 and tonight was 2:28.
That's better.
Yeah. And I was going to ask you, compare the way you guys as a team played tonight as opposed to last night. You looked a lot more comfortable.
Yes. I think last night we realized that we haven't been playing like a team, and like not as in people are selfish, but it's just like not gelling. So I think today we just were really trying to focus on like people really getting solidified in their roles that they're going to be in this year. And I think that's what helped us win today.
I want to just say, she's back. You turned it up a notch at some point. And I want to know when that happened in tonight's match. You kind of changed. All of a sudden, you were hitting the ball a heck of a lot harder.
I think since Taylor got in, it kind of took away some responsibilities that I had passing-wise. So I think it helped me focus more on hitting and blocking and stuff like that. And then I think Taylor went out there and really did her job today. So, yeah, that helped a lot.
Talk a little bit about the position that you play in that 0-1 position. We see you in serve receive hitting twice from the left, once on the right. Mm-hmm. You seem confident on both pins. I mean, explain, you know, just the evolution of your role having to hit maybe in those different positions, and if there's a preference or what that's like for you hitting in these different areas.
I don't really mind outside or right side either way. But I think basically my role is just to help the team get kills and get points. And they're doing a great job getting a perfect pass to Kate. So I have to just finish out my job, and that's getting a kill. So, yeah.
Well, this past summer, you guys, or at least eight of you, went up to Brazil representing the Rainbow Wahine. And we talked to Coach Robin earlier this week, and she said you were one of the players she thought that took the most away from that trip to Brazil, getting a chance to see a higher level of volleyball. Mm-hmm. What did you learn most from that trip?
A lot of the players we saw in Brazil were like very tiny, and they were getting successful on us because they were just swinging high, and they were just like fearless against us because they were like 5'9", and then Amber's like 6'3", blocking them, and they like don't care. They're just taking rips. So I think that helped me a lot, realizing that like hands are useful, and just like reaching the ball at a high contact. I already have like a high vertical, so just making sure I'm staying at my high point, and then it just helps out like in the end with my attack.
Tell the viewing audience a little. This has become one of my favorite questions. I don't know why, but I just like to ask, what is your pregame like ritual? Not with the team per se, but something that you do to kind of fire yourself up.
My pregame ritual, I like to now just visualize like what the game is going to look like, and basically just like helping myself calm down because these games are really intense with all the fans. And so I just like to kind of just go over scouting reports and all that stuff, and I listen to music, and I always need something sweet, so I have like some Skittles or something munching on them while I'm going.
Now, what's your music taste? You got to tell us what you listen to.
I like, before a game, I like to listen to Beyonce because I love Beyonce a lot.
Who doesn't?
Exactly.
You got good taste.
I love her. And I just...
It's true.
So I love listening to Beyonce before games, or just like, not music that gets me too riled up, like rap music. That one gets me a little too, like...
Too much.
That and the sugar?
It's a little too aggressive,
Yeah, back...
So, yeah, I like to listen to Beyonce before games.
Now, we know your mother,
yes,
back home, watches religiously. Before we say goodbye to you,
yes,
why don't you say have a few words, you and her.
Hi, Mom. Thanks so much for staying up late watching. Today, we're not up that late. And also, I'm going to say hi to Cameron and Camille. They were a little jealous last time I didn't say hi. Those are my two sisters.
Oh, of course.
Right. So, there you go.
Yeah, it's only like 4 in the morning there or something right now.
Literally.
It's still early. It's literally early. Hey, congratulations.
Thank
15
you.
Kills. Keep doing it. Tomorrow night, you guys got a big chance to make a big statement against Oregon.
Exactly. Super excited for tomorrow.
All right. Kaylin Alexander helped lead Hawaii here tonight to a 4-set win over number 13 San Diego. We'll take a break. Come back and have more from the corner.